Hi, I'm Billy Kidman, and this is my friend Xenia, and we're here in Melbourne 16 years later after first meeting at a charity dinner. So in 2002, there was a charity dinner when WWE's in town for global warming, and we were at the same table, and we basically talked all night and hit it off, and it ended with that. 2 years later, we randomly ran into each other in the United States through the same charity, where she won a trip. When I walked in there, I just locked eyes and I just knew she looked familiar. I couldn't place it, but she told me about it, where, from where. And then that was the second random meeting. I don't know what it was or why, but she just always kind of stuck with me in my mind. Just always kind of wondered whatever happened to her and, you know, if she made it through. And so once we reconnected, we've been in touch ever since. And now 16 years later, as you can see, healthy, beautiful, she made it through. And so it's a good feeling to know that even though, like, you know, what we do as superstars, we don't think of a lot, I don't anyway, as far as the actual impact that I have. But the impact that we also receive sometimes is something that really doesn't get brought up much.
So I was diagnosed with leukemia in 2002, and I was only 15, and I spent most of the time in the hospital, unable to get out. And the charity I work with, Challenge, said, "We've got this wrestling event, we've got a charity dinner if you want to come along." And fortunately, I was well enough to go, and they let me meet Billy that night. And I guess when you're so sick, I mean, I had no hair, I was barely allowed out of the hospital at that time, to get the opportunity to meet someone that you're like, these are heroes, you know, for that one night, for that 20 minutes or that 2 hours, you forget that you're actually really sick and you might lose your life. And for me, that was something that always stuck in my mind. I never forgot it. And 16 years later, it's still one of my strongest memories. I just always wondered if he thought about it or it crossed his mind. So now to actually be here with him and know that he remembered it, and not only that, he was touched by the experience like I was, pretty special. I don't think many people get that kind of experience in their lifetime.
I actually saved a message that she sent. She asked about the impression that she made on me, and I said, why did I make an impression on you? And she said, easy to answer. At that point in my life, things were pretty difficult. I was so sick. I'd gone from being an active young girl to a baby again. That night, I was lucky to be allowed to the hospital to go, and then meeting you was an incredible bit of light in a really dark time. You were so warm and open. You treated me like a normal person. You seemed genuinely interested in being there at that moment with me. You just were a kind soul. After my uncle bid on the front row tickets for the WWE in Melbourne, and you stopped during your performance and gave me a hug ringside, it was such a massive moment for me, and who does that? You really should be proud of yourself, and you should... And so should your mom, because you're a good human being. And so it was one of the nicest messages I ever got. And so it's very special for me right now.